Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to St. Stephen Walbrook for this afternoon organ recital. Gives me great pleasure today for William Saunders, again playing for us, and you're in for an absolute treat. And thank you, William, for coming today and playing for us. Can I just bring to your attention that on the way out, if you're able to make a donation, that'd be very much appreciated. That could be done by contactless, or that could be done by cash at the back. Thank you very much, and the recital is about to start.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Great to see everyone. I expect I've played many recitals here before, and the crowd has been bigger. I think the weather's perhaps put everyone off, but it's great to see those of you that are here. A bit of a regal program, perhaps I'm a month or two out of date, but I thought, why not on this instrument, good old English Victoriana, otherwise known as slush in my book, musical slush, actually would fit very well on this instrument. So that was good old Walton, written for the coronation of Queen Elizabeth II. It's, as I said, got a regal theme throughout this entire program. And moving on to the next set of pieces that I'm going to play, Solemn Melody, which is actually played during the coronation of King George VI. It was originally written as a hymn tune, but it was so popular that actually he transcribed it for organ and various other concoctions, for strings as well. It's got a wonderfully rich melody that you'll hear appearing at a number of points. There's a bit of an Elgar fest in the middle of the program, Imperial March, which actually started its life as a song, a vocal setting of Rudyard Kipling's poem For All We Have and Are, which was written to honour the fallen of the British soldiers of the First World War. That was performed, written for the Diamond Jubilee of Queen Victoria. Then we rattle on to a wonderful miniature piece by Butterworth, George Butterworth. He wrote very little, this piece was written at a stage of unrest, obviously, in the whole world. And this was very much a patriotic piece, which meant and still does mean a great deal to a lot of people. It's a wonderfully crafted melody which builds in intensity as the piece progresses, and then it kind of fades out to nothing towards the end. It's quite beautiful. And then we move on to a bit more Elgar, a march from the Crown of India. This was written for the coronation of King George V and Queen Mary as Emperor and Empress of India. Elgar says that there's meant to be some Indian influences in this march. If you can hear them, then you're better than I am. I can't hear them. But it's not an often performed little march. It's got all of the Elgarian elements, good tune, and lots of fanfares. Nimrod leads, needs a little introduction. It's been played at many state occasions since it was composed in 1899, I think it was. It oozes patriotism and pride and wonderful piece. Works very well on this instrument. And then a bit of Jupiter to finish up with. Hopefully the organ will behave and we'll get through the endless semiquavers of this arrangement. It's rather fiddly, and this instrument goes at only one speed. It doesn't like lots of fast music very much, but it's managed pretty well so far. I was told earlier that the whole of the tower and the organ is leaning outwards by 6 inches, so it's amazing that it's still here. Anyway, hope you enjoy the rest of the program.
Thank you.
Thank you ever so much, William, for playing for us today, and hope that you come back very soon. Thank you very much.